My interest started when I was a practitioner dealing with clients who needed home care, elderly people who were living out in the community. And we would come across these very difficult situations where family members were either neglecting, mostly neglecting, the older adult. Sometimes it was evident, the type of neglect. Other times it was more subtle. Okay, and sometimes there was, you could see that the relationship either between a brother and a sister, between a parent and a son, between a couple, you could see that the family dynamics, that there was something going on. We didn't call it abuse then. We called it a really tough situation, very complex. So I think that's where my interest started. And at that time, I'm talking 30 years ago, so it's a long time. We were just beginning to talk about elder abuse. And we were just beginning to put a name to it. We're still, even then, is it elder abuse, is it senior mistreatment? The debate was even going on 30 years ago. And the first papers were coming out, the first conferences were coming out on elder abuse. And it interested me, and I realized I had a certain amount of my clients that were in abusive situations. But there was very little knowledge. And that's what made me interested in it. And on my initiative and with the support of my organization, I wanted to be able to study and learn more about this type of population. And without knowing it, I started to embark on research. But I didn't call it research then either. I thought I was just gathering information. So I wanted to develop a screening tool to identify how many clients we had that lived in abusive types of situations. And I developed a tool, not scientifically, okay, had no methodology, just basically looked at the literature, put down the questions I thought were pertinent. I developed a protocol and an intervention guide, and I did 1 year where I identified how many people would we define as being in abusive situations without using my tool, and then compared it with a year later where I made every single social worker use that tool. And I did a comparison, and I saw that, wow, when we asked the questions, we identified at least 8 times as many people that were in abusive situations. So then I realized, we have an issue, and we have an issue that needs to be treated. So then, after you identify, what do you do? What's best practice? Okay, what are the dynamics? What are the laws? So all of those things, one thing led into another. But it really started from practice, and my goal was always, how can I help practice? How can I identify how to prevent? How can I identify how to intervene? How can I identify how to stop? How can I also ensure that we respect the rights of the older person? Okay, because we also talk about older people who, some of them were competent. Some of them had cognitive impairment. Their family members, very important. So all of those issues were going on in my mind as a practitioner, and also was information and issues that other people were concerned about as well. So that's how I started. So really, not intentionally, but I got my foot in, wrote a small article on that, and then it just took off.